Hi there! In this video, you'll learn how to build a portal by watching me walk through the high-level flow. Later, you can build your own portal if you complete the step-by-step tutorial that accompanies our Create a User Experience course. A portal is a great way to extend your Appian data and workflows to unauthenticated users. These users may be your partners or customers who don't have access to your Appian environment, but still need to view or share information with your apps. They may need to view a dashboard, request a new account, or report an incident. This is where portals come in handy. Today, I'll show you how to build a portal for the customers of Wyndham Power. This portal allows the customers of this power giant to easily report power outages by submitting an outage form, available from a public URL. I already built a couple of objects for the Wyndham Power Outage app that I'll need for my portal: a simple form for reporting outages, and a process model for launching repairs. Let's start by reviewing the form and the process model. You'll build the primary interface for a portal the same way you build any other interface in Appian, but with one key difference. The primary interface can't use rule inputs, so you'll need to use a local variable instead. In this interface, I used the expression mode to add a local variable called local bang application, and then configured the display value and save input two properties for each address field using this variable. I also already have a process model that will be launched after a customer submits the form. After the customer reports an outage, the process model writes data and assigns a repairs task to the technicians group. After a task is completed, the status gets updated and the process ends. Because a portal runs outside of the main Appian environment, you'll need to set up a connection between the portal and Appian. This is done using a web API and an integration. A web API will create an endpoint for the portal to connect to, and the integration, once referenced by the portal interface, will connect to Appian. I'll start by generating an API key for my web API, which is done from the administration console. This key will be used for authentication. While here, I'll also create a service account. A service account is used for security, to ensure that Wyndham customers only have the access they need. Now I have the API key, so let's copy it to a separate text file. Also, I'll add my new service account as a user to this app's All Users group. This step will ensure that customers have sufficient permissions to share information with Appian. Next, let's create a web API. For this portal, I'll use the Start Process template. This is because my portal will launch a process in Appian. However, there are other templates to choose from. For example, you can select Query Record Type if you want your portal to display data from Appian, or select Write Records if you want to write data. I'll use a constant that points to my process model and will fill out the remaining details: the name of this web API, description, the endpoint, and then I'll accept the default security settings. This web API is almost ready to go, but I'll update the process parameter to include outage, which is the parameter used in my process. To finish up, let's copy this web API URL to a text file. I'll need it for my integration. When working with integrations, you should always save the connection details using a connected system object. This way, you can reuse the same connected system across multiple integrations. Here, I'll add the web API URL and API key that I copied earlier, and also the header name. I can create the new integration directly from this dialog. Let's name it, add a quick description, and now I only need to add a few details for this integration to be fully functional. First, I'll add the endpoint outage in the relative path field and select post as my method. Second, let's add the rule input. Like in other places in my app, the rule input will be outage of the power outage record type. Finally, I'll type RI bang outage into request body and add abing to JSON to make sure the response from this integration is converted to JSON. Keep in mind, it's always a best practice to test an integration. I'll skip the testing steps, but you can learn how to test by completing the Build a Portal tutorial. Finally, let's add this new integration to the Submit button in my primary interface. I'll select the button, and we'll update the Save Value to call the integration. I'll type RuleBang and then the name of my integration. Notice that the wizard below is assisting me with the syntax of this expression. Now, I only need to add the text for the confirmation header. Let it be, "Your outage was reported. A technician will contact you within 24 hours," and label the buttons. The last step in portal development is to create a portal object. This object will orchestrate all parts that I've built so far into a working portal. I'll name this portal, and I'll set the display name to Report Outages. This is the name that end users will see in their browser tab. To begin, I'll select the primary interface in the content field. Notice that you can immediately preview your interface in the branding preview. I'll add the service account next, which will provide the end user with the permission to view and share the information. Let's save and publish this portal. Once the portal is published, which may take a few minutes, it becomes available to users at the specified URL. You can preview it by clicking this hyperlinked web address. I can easily test this portal by submitting a quick outage request, and then reviewing the process instance to see that the data was recorded. By the way, the portal will retain its status as published upon its deployment to other environments. Let's recap what you've learned so far. The primary interface for a portal can't use rule inputs. Use local variables instead. Use a web API and an integration to connect the portal to your Appian environment. Use the portal object to configure and publish your portal. The portal will remain published upon deployment to other environments. For additional details, visit Appian documentation.